protein is a complex amino acid structure. So when you have a complex amino acid structure, that means you have many acids compacted into a chemical bond. You see that? And that's the reason why proteins is very, very acidic, because you have all these different acids that the body does not need. And therefore, since the body don't need it, the body cannot utilize it. And the unutilized amino acids inside the body become free radicals. And free radicals is an acidic particle that roams around at its free will in the body, just burning shit alive. So you're getting secondhand amino acids when you eat an animal. The amino acids that the animals need, they get their amino acids from all plant-based products. They get it from hay, get it from grass, get it from fruits. They get it from everything that comes from a plant. Even the animals got to go through their metabolic process as well, right? So the animals eat the actual amino acids, not protein, but the animals eat the simple amino acids from their plants, and then they utilize it and they metabolize those amino acids. You then kill the animal and you eat the animal for protein, which is complex amino acids that it already metabolized from the plants. So even when you're eating protein, you're not even getting the amino acids that you need, because it have already been utilized from the plant amino acids that became protein from the animals eating it and going through its digestive process. See that? Look, if you really look at protein on any level, there is nothing good about protein. And when I mean protein, I mean anything that comes from an animal. That's including eggs, that's including milk, that's including anything that come from an animal. The proteins in it is impossible to be broken down by your biochemical makeup. And that's the reason why these proteins is messing us up, because you cannot fully digest the protein, because you don't have none of the alkaline enzymes to digest this protein. You don't have none of the physiological aspects to break down and digest this protein. You don't have the high acidity or hydrochloric acid inside your stomach sac to even break down these proteins. Nor do you have the bicarbonate that you need, nor the trypsin from the pancreas to break down these proteins, nor do you have the bile or basal sauce that's produced by the liver that's stuck inside the gallbladder to even break down these fats. Nothing inside of your body can break down proteins. So what if the body cannot break it down and the body can't use it? The body have a way of storing shit up. So it just start putting stuff in pockets everywhere. Then you start seeing lipids swole. Now you start seeing your skin starts pooping on itself, or you start seeing tumors forming, big old cysts form everywhere, because it don't know what to do with all the lipids and all the proteins. And mucus is going to steady come and try to heal the day. When mucus come, you already know magnesium coming. If magnesium coming, calcium monotriphosphate gotta come. So now you crystallizing and you calcifying these meats, and you calcifying these complex amino acid structures that you call protein. Calcium and acids and mucus do not go good together. And that's the reason why you put people on herbs and you put them on all fruit diets and they have tons and tons of plaque, mucinoid plaque that's shaped like their intestines that comes through their anus, because that was all protein that could not be utilized by the body. Now, guess what happens to the body if you can't get that stuff out? Guess what happens? It starts to break down and corrode the cells. Do you know what a broken down, corroded cell is called? In clinical trials, we call that cancer.
Cancer is actually a group of over 100 diseases characterized by abnormal and uncontrolled cell growth.